Hello, welcome. So, is that timer? Did I not go over? I've been asked to do this in English. My English is not perfect, so I need a little help. Okay, my perfect copyright. Before I start with the thing, we have to mention the question. Copyright and choreography, does they go together at all? I think yes. Even dances and choreographies are copyrighted in Germany. In Germany's copyrights law, it's clearly established that all the works of the art of dance are covered by copyright law, paragraph 2, number 3 of the Copyright Act. So, in Germany, therefore, the dance art is copyrighted. However, but the art of dance leads a pronounced shadow life, I would call it, under copyright literature. Few essays and decisions deal with the issue of protection. But what is actually copyrighted dancing? This question, I think, is clear to clear. And a lot of laws try to do this. So I figured a couple of things out, what is written about this. So before this question can be answered, it must be first clarified what is actually dancing in the heuristic sense. The literature and case law are trying to answer in that dance is regarded as an expression of feelings and thoughts contained by body language. Certainly a bulky definition, I would say. That the choreographic work is protected of the copyright law, the copyrights always presupposes a personal intellectual creation. What is needed is a human creation, creative activity that makes a spiritual content perceptible and which the individuality of the creator is manifested. A choreography is an expression of dance is protected as a rule when come the individual thoughts and ideas of the choreographer together. So I think this is an official definition, quite bulky, like I said, quite unclear, because this is the problem a little bit of dance and choreography, that it's often between the arts. So, but the situation in German state and city theaters is even more complicated. I work quite often, also beside my freelance works, I work quite often in German city state theaters, and I had a lot of discussion with German intendants about copyright and authorships. Because it means if you get it on a state theater, they have to pay 10 times. For the following performances. Of course, this the people don't want. But on the state theaters, this is very, very normal to do it with authors of an acting piece. This is used, it's normal, it's done, but for dance and ballet, the people have to fight. Even there is this big discussion if somebody's doing the Prokofiev, Romeo and Juliet. It is not a world premiere, but of course the choreographer is doing a complete new step movement material for it. So it is, on the other hand, also a world premiere. But this you never get through in Germany on a state theater to get an authorship for this, and so that other paid 10 times. What I did all the time in the German state theaters is really to fight for it when there was a new creation, only not to name it premiere, to name it a world premiere. So with this, you have already a copyright on it. So this is very important. And I really fight it through that I, for the further performances, we paid 10 times. Even it's just a little thing, even it's just a euro, but with this is manifested that your copyright, even on a state theater, is on. However, so it's another question with this, what is with little themes and movements and little sequences? Is this copyrighted in Germany or worldwide? It's also interesting what it is in the law and written. However, the question raised as to what extent individual sequences, patterns, or even poses may be considered eligible for protection. The jurists agree that not every human body movement is copyright protected as choreographed work, because then it starts to become really complicated. So I move this. This is now already copyrighted otherwise. Mirror body control, artistic or athletic and achievements should be distinguished from the copyright dance. A simple rotation, a roll on the ground, or a mere hand position cannot enjoy copyright protection. But when there is a short sequence, like movements of a clear signature, and there's a combination of movements, space, expressions, and costuming, as an intellectual creation, it is also copyrighted. So even short completed sequences of an overall choreography can be copyright protected. For this, there's a very good example, because there was a big battle between Beyoncé and Andries de Kersmarker because of a video from 2001. The name of the video was from Beyoncé's Countdown, her song Countdown. What happened? It existed in this, with this theme in the dance scene and also among lawyers, a discussion of whether the music video of the US-American pop and media star Beyoncé does not infringe the copyright of the renowned Belgian choreographer Andries de Kersmarker. The video of Beyoncé considered as many points with the original of Kersmarker's from the 80s. In both videos, a woman stands in front of a window, running her hand through her open long hair, let slip a gray t-shirt from her right shoulder, while four other dancers are seen in the background dancing. Also, the location and empty factory building looks in the two videos almost the same. Besides this, there are more sequences in both videos which resemble each other. Andries de Kersmarker has instructed her lawyers directly with the examination of this happening after the announcement of the video. At the end, there was a comparison. Kersmarker would be called as an inspiration source. After the director of the video admitted the following statement, clearly the ballet Rosas, Dance Rosas, was one of many references for my video, Countdown. It was one of the inspiration used to bring the feel and look to the song, to life. So in the end, nothing happened. So you see, it's very hard to make really copyright, not only on ideas of the dance, of the movements, of what you create. It's a big discussion, and it's also very different in every country. So in Germany, it is quite on the point, but even not. So for me, my perfect copyright, it's really hard. I fight for this already for a long time. When I have been director on a state theater, I was member of the BBTK, what's a very complicated thing. It's Deutsche Ballett- und Tanztheater Direktorenkonferenz. And this was, it's still, and it was in this time, it's like 15 years ago, a very important scene to cover and also go through this fight with intendants, so to fight for this copyright, especially on state and city theaters in Germany. So I think I have to look on the, yeah? Okay, we have a little bit time for questions now. Is anyone to this subject any questions? Then I thank you very much for your patience. Have a great day. Bye.